Morning, everybody. It's a Flat Cap Cafe Racer, and it's Tuesday. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you on a walk down the aisle on all these bikes downstairs. Then we're going to go upstairs in the mezzanine and see some more. So this is going to be a peek, so I'm not going to stop and do a lot of looking here on some of these. I've already did that yesterday, and I'll have a video out on that. On a lot of those yesterday. I did about 80 bikes yesterday. So you can see that video and see how that turned out, a little bit more in depth. But this is kind of a flyby. There's over, I think, 2,000 bikes here. So there's a lot of bikes to see. So we can't stop and look a lot, but we can see. I want to show you what kind of stuff they got here. Stand by.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Did you ever meet my dad? This is my dad.
No, sure. I don't think I met.
I'm Ken.
You were with him when we were
last time. Yeah.
Last time.
Yeah, we'd have been here.
Hey guys, I'm running to Dylan from Throttle Company. Where's your better half?
Oh, she's stayed behind.
I remember she said she didn't like
it. Yeah, we were just talking about that. She's too much noise and commotion and.
Well, if anybody's watching this and you want a Royal Enfield, you want a Moto Guzzi or a vintage bike, you see Dylan over in Throttle Company in Columbus, Ohio, right?
That's right. That's
all
right.
Right.
You got it. My whole intro figured out.
Well, no, I don't know about that, but good to see you here. The 250 Elsinore, to be very familiar to some of you. 250 Yamaha, a very nice 100 Honda, an Osa. Here's something that's a little older. It's a 106, it's a 1957 James Comet. Oh my, here's an Allstate. 1954 Allstate 175. A 1960, a 59 Gorilla. Here's a Moto Guzzi. I think this one's 1958. I did a film on the 1961 yesterday. Oh, isn't this just a special road racer? 1980 Honda MT125R Mark IV. That's kind of lovely. We may take a little peek at that one. This is New Hudson. It was popular when Mr. Bill was a kid. We'll skip this one. I don't know what electric stuff. Still making sort of these. This is 2008. That's a nice model. I'll go around. It's all right. I can go around you. I just know. You don't see a lot of dual sport purpose bikes here at Kajiva. I did a little something on this Alizura here yesterday. Not a lot of late model stuff other than the. I cannot find any R100Rs. A lot of Triumphs in the 60s and 50s. There's a Whizzer. Suzuki. 1967 Honda C110. Can't keep them in stock now, new ones. Oh, I don't know whose idea to build that was, but it's not a good one. Something you don't see too much. This is a R1200S. 2007. This was a good idea. This one was a good idea, but didn't work out quite right. I never did care for the boxiness of this one, but Bandit Man UK, there's a 250 Yamaha, but it's not an LC. This was a 73 RD250. I think this one kind of wet its diapers here. Hi. That's all right. These surprisingly did not sell well. I did a little something on this Suzuki 250 Hustler yesterday. Here's another bad seller from Harley-Davidson. A Buell. A Roncon. I saw one of these bikes come in the other day, and it had dirt underneath it. I mean, they didn't even clean off the dirt on it. That's not the usual, but that's what happened. Take you down this nice, we'll go down this row here, then come back up. There's a few Ducatis here. I did something on this Ducati Passo yesterday. Nice AJS, huh? Going back to 1929. Hello. 1946 James Single. A few little early mini bike things. Now this one's, we'll stop and look at this one a little bit. This is a little unusual, isn't it? Spindly a little forks on this with a Sportster engine. Gas shocks. Flat track style, you know. Says it's a 1967 Sportster engine, 4-speed. Some sprints here, 250 sprints. The auction will probably start about 9 o'clock, so this noise will pick up a little bit. Another 77 350 SS 350s, a couple of them here. I did a little something on those yesterday. So R75 6. You know, Indian's been through so many configurations and ownerships. This is 1973. They had a big blowout special with a bunch of guy that used to do Greaves parts yesterday, with all kinds of carburetors, frames, and everything. Also had it with this CZ. Had a nice sign from the Greaves and CZ. Some more Greaves. Gonna make a circle here. I used to ride these three-wheelers a lot. They were fun, but they are very difficult to ride and ride well. I think this is another Paso I showed yesterday. I think there's about three apostles here. They're all white. Passport. We got a rotary valve RE5 coming up here. There you go. They only had that instrument cluster for what, 1 year?
How many years did they make the rotors? Two or three?
About two or three.
That's
instrument.
That's a bike that's going to be worth a lot of money someday, but they just haven't hit it. Nobody's crazy over them yet, but they're going to go.
Now there's a rotary Wankel engine Commander, Norton Commander over there.
Is there? I didn't see it.
It's a police bike.
Oh, pretty cool. Pretty interesting.
Look, everybody's taking pictures.
They want that one.
We'll get out of your way.
Oh, you look more.
You got high tech.
You guys want the Odyssey? Did you see the Pilot?
Yes. Yeah.
Here's a Hodaka. 77 Hodaka. And another Combat Wombat. Oh, yeah. A DKW 73. Not too many DKWs here, I don't think. Like a lot of dirt bikes. There's two or three of these, and I can see why, the FT500s. Nobody really wanted them. I had one of the sorriest bikes I ever owned. But I met a gentleman here yesterday, he said he had his, he loved it. So there you go, just the difference. I did one Snolly's Kawasaki 500 for Mr. Bill yesterday, so that'd be on yesterday's video if you want to see more of those. This is always a lovely bike, I thought. This 500 Interceptor, you know, that was kind of like, if I'd had the money, that's what I had bought. You gotta ask yourself, what were the Japanese thinking when they did this? Does that remind you of Chopper, man? I don't know. They do these bikes well. Can't believe this doesn't have a headlight shell with it. So you see bikes in all kinds of shape here. And these are not great shape, and that's what you see mostly on the dirt bikes, trail bikes. It's got the leading link front end on that? And you see also, it's surprisingly, you'll see some of the older Triumphs, you know, and kind of like this. But then again, you see some in some good riding condition like this one here. Very nice. This is a 65 TR6. I was looking for one of these TR6s the other day and couldn't find it. This is a Zuki 66, Zuki T10. Oh my, it's beauty. It's beauty. It's beauty. Still making these, huh? There's a Pinton 6-day. Used to be very popular in the 70s. So were the 350 Yamahas. It's a CX500 Custom. I understand pretty good bikes. I just never appealed to me. You know, the turbo would be more my line, I think. 175 Honda. This is one of these. I don't know what kind of Indians this is. This is 1987 Suzuki Indian Custom. When it got all done, he's still riding a single cylinder vibrated, but it is pretty. I gave him that. Some old Yamaha. We met. It's a Honda automatic. They were doing them way back when. This is a 77 Honda automatic. Not in too great shape. Another Hodaka. Yamaha. Pinton. I think it was a 125. Look like here's a BSA 71 B50 motocross. That must have been a heck of a man to do that. We have some mini bikes, Hondas, and this is a Pope. 1913 Pope. It's an old, there's an Indian 4. It's a 1939 Indian 4.
It's all the condition.
1969 Harley Sportster. Canary yellow, black.
Halloween Day 1996.
It's Bumblebee. That looks pretty nice, actually. I like it. Here's a Sears. Now we're going to take a look at a couple of choppers here. There is some bling. It says wind cutter fairing. I don't know, let's take off of the wind jammer or what? GPZ 750. There's a few empty spots here. I've been looking for some of the bikes that are in empty spots. Quite a few dirt bikes here, but like I said, adventure bikes, not so much. This is a real, these are really nice bikes. But yesterday, I think I did something on one of these. This is a 1962 Harley. Yeah, I did one on the Scat. It's a 165cc here. But how cool for little motorcycles, huh? The Nighthawks here, two of them. Honda 450 from, is that the Black Bomber? '74, huh? I don't remember the tanks looking like that. Yeah.
They put a 6-8 tank and a 6-8 side cover on it.
Yeah. So it's got the older. Yeah. What the, didn't they call that the Black Bomber back in 60, 66, 65?
Yeah.
All right.
He probably tried to replicate it.
He did a good job. I mean, it looks nice. There's a Gullwing. We did something on the turbos yesterday on the CX500s and CX650 turbos, if you're interested. It'd be in the previous video. This is a nice looking 81 Yamaha XS Cafe Racer. That looks really nice. They vibrate like a bunch. Here's a Ducati Scrambler with bags on it. It's 2016. I don't recall seeing one of those. There's an, got some more Ducatis, and perhaps the ugliest Ducati made right here, in my opinion. There's a Triumph America. K kind of looks like Royal Enfield, kind of copied their Meteor 650, Super Meteor. Looks a lot like that Triumph America to me. I did a little something on this one yesterday also. This is the 2002 Dnepr sidecar. Here's a 100 RS W131 1977. I think I was looking for that one of these other day. Like Mr. Bill's kind of bike right here. Honda 750. I was just watching Throttle Company had a 1974 Honda, a 750 they're selling. Really looked nice on their website. I think they picked up here a year ago. It's W84. I think that's pretty sharp. I like that. I think I showed this little trike yesterday. It's another Nighthawk. Harley Davidson scooter, the topper. It's 1960. I did a little something on this yellow bike yesterday. You had to see that. A little closer. It's a Mako, a CC, a couple of other Makos, Elsinore. Another Elsinore. Gonna skip across the aisle again. Some Yamaha trail bikes. Like I said, trail bikes are well represented. Here's your Kawasaki 1000, a ZRX 1100, which really looks nice. Trial 250 Yamaha. If you like white walls, there's your Honda coming up here. It's 1965 Honda Dream. Here's another one of the Indians. And let's see what year this was from. 19. I've only got 7 minutes left, so I can't finish this out in video, so we're going to do slides with some of the bikes that I think are very interesting. I really like. Wake up, Maggie. I think I got something to say to you. It's late September and I really should be back at school. I know I keep
rock and roll band that needs a helping hand. Oh, Maggie, I wished I'd never seen your face. You made a first-class fool out of me, but I'm as blind as a fool can be. You stole my heart, but I love you anyway.
These are the top 10 bikes showing sold as I left auction. This is a Flat Cap Cafe Racer. I hope you've enjoyed the at least 2 days of videos from the Mecum auction in 2023. There are a lot of bikes here. Couldn't stop and see each and every one of them, but the ones that you specifically asked for, I tried to do that in part one, and then part two, just kind of saw the bikes as we're walking by them and stopped and smelled the roses in a few places, but I'll take some more pictures today, and I appreciate you joining me and hope you enjoyed this video. Bye. Join me and my friends at Flat Cap Cafe Racer for riding and racing. Please subscribe.